Oh my gosh. I use Taos Basalt NL. But I love you, Henk.
You know Andreas?
Yeah. Jij bent lekker.
Zes competitiewedstrijden zat Maduka Okoye op de bank bij Sparta. Maar na het bekerduel met ADO Den Haag is hij de eerste keeper. Net als in het Nigeriaanse elftal. Als zoon van een Nigeriaanse vader en een Duitse moeder werd Okoye 21 jaar geleden geboren in Düsseldorf. Zijn achternaam stamt af van een regio in Nigeria. Maar ook zijn voornaam Maduka heeft een bijzondere betekenis.
The name means that God created nothing bigger than humans. So we as human beings should not put money or material stuff over ourselves and over the people next to you.
Okay. And do you agree with that?
Yes, I agree 100%.
Yeah?
Yes.
Money is not so important for you.
Yeah, it's important of course, but it's no way more important than a human being. That's why the name. I'm very happy that my papa gave me this name.
Het is tijd voor een nadere kennismaking met Maduka Okoye. En dat doen we aan de hand van vier keuzes.
So, both cities are unbelievable beautiful. But of course, Düsseldorf is my city, you know. But to be honest, I really fell in love with Rotterdam straight away when I came here.
Yeah, why?
It's a beautiful city. And when I came here, I sometimes thought about Düsseldorf, you know, because they have something in common. And
they both have a port.
Yes, that's it. And all the lights. But of course, I was born and raised here. That's why I would pick Düsseldorf.
Yeah. Why did you choose for Sparta Rotterdam 6 months ago?
Yeah, because I had a good feeling, my agency also let me know about the plan we have, and that why Sparta sounds very good and interesting for me.
But I guess you never heard about Sparta.
Yeah, I did. In the youth, I think I played already against them.
At the tournament?
Yeah, tournaments. We had a lot of tournaments here in the Netherlands. Always the biggest tournaments, I think, was here in the Netherlands. I had with Leverkusen or Mönchengladbach. And that's why I think sometimes Sparta was with it. And that's why I knew the club. And
And where do you live in Rotterdam? In the city center? Or?
Right here in the Lee Towers.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you cook by yourself or? Because
no.
You're living alone, right?
Yeah, I live alone.
Yeah.
Yeah, but sometimes I try to do it by myself, but it's not too easy. That's why I use Taos Besorgt NL.
That's correct.
Yeah.
And then you don't offer junk food? Only healthy food?
No, yeah, sometimes. But most of the time, like pasta and rice. I have a very good Nigerian restaurant here. I found one, thank God.
In Rotterdam?
Yeah, in Rotterdam.
Okay.
Because I need my Nigerian food at least once a week. And I found a very good one. And
Okay. I heard that you came to the Netherlands more often as a little boy, right?
With the tournaments.
Not on holiday or?
No, not on holiday.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, because I guess that you visited Hoek van Holland earlier than.
Before I signed here.
Yeah.
I've been to Hoek van Holland.
To
the beach, and it's a beautiful beach. I've been there the night before the match against PSV, so on Saturday.
Okay.
Again, just for a walk and get in the fresh air and
alone.
And a clean mind and
Okay.
Yeah, I like to do it.
Listening some music,
yes,
I guess.
Exactly.
What kind of music?
Nigerian music most of the time, sometimes to Dutch music.
Really?
Yeah.
Like what?
Like Frenna, Brüderliefde.
Really?
Jonah Fraser, yeah.
Okay.
In Germany, it's actually very big Dutch music.
Broederliefde as well?
Not Broederliefde, but like Frenna and Lil Kleine or Boef.
Yeah?
Yeah, they're big in Germany.
But do they sing in Dutch or in German over there?
No, in
Dutch.
In Dutch, yeah. Even in clubs or in bars, they play Dutch music. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So no André Hazes, but Leo Kleine. You know André Hazes?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, exactly. When you came for the first time at the Lee Towers, the place where you live, mm-hmm. You saw a girl behind the desk. Mm-hmm. What did you say?
I think jij bent lekker. But that was just pure intention. I wasn't supposed to say it, but it just popped out of my mind.
She was really lekker.
Yeah, she was lekker.
Do you know them?
Yeah, Vincent Enyama and Rufai.
Peter Rufai.
Yeah. Yeah, because I definitely watch more of Enyama, and he's more from my
generation.
I go with Enyama, and yeah, for me he's definitely the greatest Nigerian goalkeeper ever, and also one of the best African, and one of the best ever played in a French league. That's why I pick Enyama. Yeah.
Do you know Peter Rufai?
Yeah, I know him, but not as a person. Mm-hmm. So, I think he was the first Nigerian goalkeeper to play here in the Netherlands,
yeah,
with the Go Ahead Eagles. And but of course I know more of Enyama.
And he was also the goalkeeper during Nigerian's World Cup '94.
Yes, exactly. That was the dream team, the '94 World Cup.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With all the big players,
yes,
like
big
Amokachi,
exactly.
Yekini.
Exactly, yeah. I see, you know it.
That was my generation.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah, when I was a small boy,
yeah,
I looked up to them. Sunday, yeah. Olise later.
Yeah.
A lot of Nigerian, yeah, superstars.
Yeah, great players.
Vincent Enyama played at France.
Yeah.
What's your favorite competition?
My dream is the Premier League. And that's the best competition for me in England.
Yep.
Yeah.
And who was your idol?
Nelson Dida is my idol, yeah.
He played for Milan, right?
Yes, yeah. For me, he was the greatest. I love his style and everything. And yeah. But for nowadays, it's Ter Stegen for me. Marc-Andre Ter Stegen, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Not Andre Onana?
Yeah, also a great goalkeeper. I love to watch him, and
Is he the best African goalkeeper at this moment?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Yes.
And you're the second one?
Mendy from Chelsea.
Oh, yeah, of course. Oh, yeah. Number three is also good.
Yeah.
I don't
know.
What does it mean?
Yeah, that's great. So whoever did this,
I did it.
Wow. So
because,
do you want me to explain it?
Yeah, please. Because under every Instagram post,
yeah,
I see those hashtags.
Yeah.
But I don't understand why.
I'm gonna explain. 40 is my city, it's Düsseldorf. And 227 is my hood, it's Oberbix, where I actually grew up in Düsseldorf. So 40227 is the postcode of Düsseldorf and my place.
Aha.
Yeah. So 40 or 227. Yeah, you know, actually it's 1, but it's 227. It's the place where I grew up, where I've been raised.
Can you describe your youth?
Yeah, I was actually going to school, and straight after school, outside with the boys, kickball and doing also a bit of trash and shit, but
yeah, like what?
Yeah, we did a lot, but I just can say I'm very blessed with my youth, and I'm really thankful for this kind of youth, because I think this made me the person I am today, and I'm grateful for every friend I had in my youth in this 227. And yeah, that's why I represent it everywhere, on every post I have it, and yeah, that's why.
And you spoke German?
Yeah,
yep.
Yes.
What was your situation when you were really young? What did your father do for a living?
Yeah, a lot of working. My father and my mother. Yeah, it was not always easy, but they tried their best to make it as easy as possible for us, for me and my brother. And that's why I'm very thankful for their hard work, that me and my bro can enjoy our youth. And yes, my father is a legend in 227.
Yeah.
Why? It's like everybody knows him there because on the playground he was always with us and he brought all the stuff, the table tennis, the balls, and when there was problem my father was always there. And yeah, everybody loved him in the hood. I still loves him and everybody's greeting him, and I get always messages, how's your papa? Your papa is such a great guy.
What's his name?
Amobi.
Amobi.
Amobi Anthony Okoye, yeah. Yes, and yeah, I'm really blessed with my parents, and yeah.
So he's the chief of 227.
Exactly, he's the chief of 227. Yeah, you can really say it.
Yeah.
when you go to 227 and just talk about Amobi, everybody will know him.
Okay.
Even if they don't know you know.
So after the Corona crisis, we go with TV Raymond to 227 to
promise.
Yeah.
Promise.
Deal.
Promise. That's the deal. Oh my gosh.
Gernot Rohr, the head coach of Nigeria, or Henk Vrezer?
Yeah, both are great guys. I know Gernot Rohr for a little bit longer. And yeah, I'm very, very grateful for him because he gave me a big chance in my career and like a starting shot in my career, you know, pushing me inside a game against Brazil in the 36th minute. And I was young and not experienced. And yeah, that's why I'm very grateful for him. But do I really have to choose now one?
Yes.
Yeah, that's for this, I have to go with Gernot. But I love you, Henk. Don't kill me for this one.
What makes Henk special?
Yeah, he's the first time I saw him, I was like, wow. He's like, he was from the start, from the beginning, close to me, you know. Like, I think he's close to every player. This is very good. He's, yeah, still fresh, still good looking. So, yeah, he can keep up with us. So it's a great coach. I never experienced a coach like this, and that's why I'm really happy with him. And yeah, he's doing a great job. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
good looking. I think he's very glad of you for saying that. He looks better than Gernot Rohr.
That's true. Yeah. When I have to choose with this, I would definitely choose Henk Vrezer without thinking about it.
Dankeschön.
Ja, sehr gerne. Graag gedaan.
Alsjeblieft.
Ja. Yeah.